Good morning! It is Friday, September 26th, and yes, I am eating pizza. It's what people do here in England. They eat pizza for breakfast. It's the English way, don't diss. All right. I don't actually eat pizza for breakfast. Obviously, I was making that up. Rhiannon, stop laughing at me. Actually, I'm just hungry, and I don't like their breakfast stuff very much. They have these fried eggs. They're not scrambled. They're actually like sunny side up eggs. And they're just sitting there in this pan waiting for you to get one. But obviously, if they're like sunny side up and they're just sitting there, then they're not messy. They're not runny. They're really hard. And I'm not sure about that. I'll try one eventually, I promise. But for right now, I'm not. But they do have like this little cup of mushrooms that are really good. But I think they've been cooked in grease. I think that's what they're sitting in. But they're still good. And then hash browns. And then they have these little packets of like ketchup, you know, at the front. And normally just get those for free. It's pay 10 pence for each one. But then, just on the floor above them, there's this other little cafe place who gives the same thing away for free. So I don't get that. Anyway, it's my birthday today. I'm 20 years old. I didn't even realize until about an hour ago, after I'd already been up for an hour or so, that it was my birthday. And I was like, oh yeah, oh. It's not that big a deal. Because I'm not at home where it can be a big deal. And it's just 20, which is like nothing, you know? You're not a teenager, but you're not old enough to drink legally, as in buying it in America. So it just doesn't matter either way. Do you suppose the fact that 18 is a big year comes from here? Because when they're 18, they can drink? Because there's really, well, no, that's not true. Okay, so you can buy certain things when you're 18 and vote. Never mind, I take all of that back. Yes, I am random. Okay. I wrote down things that have happened because it's been a few days since I was here. And I haven't really gotten a chance to record all of this. So there's a lot in this entry. And oh, I'll have to get a few videos of walking around and stuff, but everything in Winchester is hilly, going down or going up. And so the camera is so shaky, it gave me a headache to watch. I'm sure it would give all of you a headache to watch. So I'll have to re-record stuff like that. Because otherwise, we'll all be sick and you won't watch my videos anymore. Someone's running the faucet. It's so loud. And by the way, they have the craziest sinks. Why didn't you tell me, Rhiannon? Here's hot and here's cold. Okay, normally those are our switches. I forgot the word. Anyway, you know how you turn on hot and turn on cold, but they both come out of the same faucet. And this one, they're separate. And they're not close enough to just kind of mix. And it's really hot and really cold, so I'm not exactly sure how to use that. Oh well. Anyway, it's just weird. Also, what also? I don't know. I don't know. You know how you can think of a million things to say, and then you actually get in front of a camera or in front of somebody and you can't think of it anymore? Yeah, that's how it is. The other night, I met this guy whose name was Nigel, and he had such an awesome accent. It was so great. I wanted to take a picture of him, but I didn't want to freak him out, you know? And they have very scary driving. I rode on the bus to go to Dr. Richardson for tea, which was really great because I was so hungry. And there was this car that I had to get up on the sidewalk to let the bus through. And the roads are only big enough for one car, yet two cars drive on them. I don't know how they do it. But I know that if anybody from America were to try to drive over here, they'd probably get in a wreck. Not just because of they drive on the other side of the road, but just because. That's crazy. We're going to London this Sunday, on a tour trip. So I'm really excited about that. And this is the end of Freshers Week, and it's been really hard and confusing. I mean, it's been great because, you know, you meet new people and you're all like, woo, new place. But at the same time, they throw a million papers at you, and this has to be done, and this has to be done, and you have to go here. Like, I have to go to a meeting in an hour. And then another meeting right after that, and then another meeting at 3. And I feel like I'm missing something in between. And you have to fill out all these papers, and I don't know. I'm not sure how to fill them out because they talk different. Like, okay, my major is psychology, but I don't have any psychology classes because they didn't sign me up for any. So I don't know which faculty I'm exactly in. Because all my classes are in the arts faculty, but obviously my major is in the social science faculty, and I don't know. And I'm trying to I'm trying to change it too. So should I go to both? I don't know. Well, look, there's all these papers, and all these papers, and this big book, and this paper, and, oh, I don't know, maybe all these papers, and all of this to read, and, I don't know. I think they could have given this to us in a better way. Just my opinion. But they did have this really great thing last night. This guy called Sam Wills came and gave this lecture. It was so awesome because he came up to the stage and he had a mustache and a beard and hair, you know? And I was like, his mustache looks funny. But then I was like, you know, whatever. And then he said he was from California. And I was like, his accent's kind of funny. And I was like, whatever, he's from California, right? Well, then he's like talking about how alcohol is actually really good for you, and there's been a lot of studies that say grades improve with it, yada yada yada. And he's like, does anyone want to sign up? And some people are like, yes, yes, yes. And then he's like, well, we're gonna do this little demonstration, and the lights go down and this music comes on, and he starts throwing off his clothes, and I'm just like, and then he takes off his hair and mustache and beard, and he's actually wearing like a tank top and jeans. He's really, really cool. I don't know, it's just so awesome. And then he did this awesome juggling, like it was glow-in-the-dark balls, and he did 3, and then he did 4, and then he did 5. It was amazing. It was really great. And then he was just funny throughout the whole thing. Like, you know when people, like, make up stories, and then they act them out? Like, Sarah was really sad to go to the store. I don't want to go to the store, blah! That kind of thing. But they just do that. He did that through the whole thing, and it was just cracking me up. I have not laughed that much in such a long time. I'm sorry all of you missed it. You might be able to find him on YouTube. Sam Wills. W-I-L-L-S. I think that's his name. Anyway, if I'm talking too fast, I'm sorry. I'm trying to shove it all in really fast so that everybody knows. What else did I do? Oh, yeah. So we walk downtown, right? We're walking, we just get through the arc, and this old woman and man come up, and they're like, do you know where Winchester Cathedral is? I'm sure that was a horrible imitation. I'm sorry if I offended anybody. And we're like, yeah, actually, you just go through there, and you go through that arc, and it should be on your left. It was just so cool, because we've been there for like one day. I barely know where anything is, and yet I just gave directions to somebody. I was like, yeah. And I have it on video, but it, like I said, it was really shaky. So I'm not gonna post it. I'm sorry. Yeah. When we were driving from the airport, from Heathrow to Winchester, just before I fell asleep because I was so tired, they pointed out the window, and there were like hills and hills and hills. It was so beautiful. But there's this one section which was just, it was huge, and it was covered in all farming. Like, all of it was, you could just see the plants growing in it. It was so cool. I don't know how to describe that, but it is. You just have to see it. You just have to see it. And the weather here has not been as cold as I thought it was, which I'm really glad about. I mean, it's very fallish, but it's like the chilly part of fall just before you get into winter. And the only thing that's cold about it really is the wind, and it's cloudy all the time. But sometimes, like yesterday, it gets sunny and it was really hot. So, I don't know. Why does a cloud stay over England? I mean, I know a cloud doesn't stay over England. Why is it known for being cloudy? Or Seattle, you know? Why is it so cloudy here? Is there like a magnetic force? It makes me think of Douglas Adams, like the fourth book, when there's that guy who was the rain god. Like the clouds liked him, so they followed him, and it was always raining wherever he was. I don't know. What else has been going on? I don't know. It's been exciting. It's been wonderful. Yesterday wasn't so great because I was just really tired and stressed, I guess. But, yep, that's what's going on with me so far. And I'm going to try to record better so that I'm not going through the whole video. So I hope everyone at home is doing well. I miss all of you. And I can't wait to record more to, you know, share. I hope that I can get some good walks into Winchester that aren't shaky, because that's really horrible. So I'll talk to all of you later. Bye. Love you. Miss you.